Hello students, welcome to Sarsanskar online classroom. Welcome to this session of our free online class of mathematics for class 6th. In this particular session, I am going to teach you about numbers. Or in this session, we are going to know about the numbers as this is our main topic. So, before starting our session, let's take an overview of it. This session is divided into three parts, which you can see behind me. The first part is introduction to counting numbers. Then the next part is comparing numbers, and the last is homework for you all. So, a lot to know, a lot to discuss. Let's begin it. Yes. Introduction to counting numbers. This is the first part of our session. Now, as you all can see two pictures behind me on the screen. In the first picture there are some chocolates, and in the second picture there are some teddy bears. What you have to do, you have to count them. First, count the number of chocolates. I also count together with you. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There are 8 chocolates. And then we count the number of teddy bears. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. There are 10 teddy bears. So, first is, how we are able to count the numbers of chocolates and the number of teddy bears is, and why there is need of counting things. So the answer is simple. Counting is required to represent a collection of objects with an exact numerical quantity. It helps to identify the larger collection in a group of collections. I am repeating it. Counting is required to represent a collection of objects. I think a collection of objects, anything. A number, object or any other thing with an exact numerical quantity. Exact numerical quantity. What is the numerical quantity? 1, 2, 3, 4 and others, so on. These are numerical quantities. There are two type of quantities. One is numeral and second one is arithmetic. Or now, it helps to identify the larger collection in a group of collections. As you see, when we are seeing the pictures, there are 8 chocolates and there are 10 teddy bears. This is a large quantity. How we are able to count them? We are able to count them with quantity, within numerical quantity. Now one question is more arised. What is counting the things is always so easy? As I say, you that count these things and you are easily count them. Is counting the things is always so easy? Then the answer is no. The counting things is always not so easy. Then, from where does this all comes? Now the counting things is easy for us now, but it is not if we always knew how to convey large quantities in conversion or through symbols. What is the symbols? You all know about the Roman numerals. In this there are 1, V and other symbols which we are used to represent the countings. For I representing the 1, then 2I representing 2nd and others. You all know about it. Now the question is arised in that how we are able to count things easy. How we are able to count things so easy. So the answer behind is this, that all this come through collective effort of human beings. All this come from collective efforts of human beings. Their path was not easy. They struggle all along the way, because if we are doing a new thing, it is never be easy. So we have to do many experiments, many painstaking experiments, and after it we get the result. The same thing they do many experiments, many other things, and then they are get a conclusion, or then they get a product of counting. Then how this counting is a part of numbers, not the complete number. Numbers not always be used to count the things. They can be used in many different ways. How we will know about these things in this chapter, that you can see that In fact, the development of whole of mathematics can be understood this way. How? Because now in nowadays, if you are seeing that mathematics is linked with human civilization, you can't deattach human civilization and mathematics. You can see mathematics everywhere. If you are seeing in the chemistry, there are the molecules, the number of molecules and the number of particles, the number, the quantity of a chemical, the all other things. Is how we all know about the quantities due to the mathematics. If you are going to the physics, if you are seeing the flow of current and other the ampere, voltmeter and the other, how we are using them with the help of numbers, all they are containing numbers on the which we can show, and all the quantities and the resistance, all other stuff we are knowing through the numbers, because and the quantities are related to mathematics. So mathematics is present in physics also. If you are seeing the biology, the what you get in there, there is also, if we are seeing the biology, the you can see the concept of biochemistry, what we are doing there. We are making their medicines and other, so what the, how the medicines are made, we use many type of chemicals and add them in a fixed quantity, and now again quantity is related to mathematics. So mathematics is interlinked or attached to human civilization. Now if we want to deattach it, it is not possible that human civilization as it is at this time will be able to, at that time when mathematics is deattached. So now we are coming back to the point that numbers are used in many different contexts. You all know in many different contexts and many other ways we use numbers, in using the addition, subtraction, multiplication and division, LCM, HCF and so on. You all know about it, Aksha, Ali and others. I think you all know about it. So what we are doing with the help of numbers, what we are doing, we add, subtract, divide, multiply and other things. In this chapter, what we are going to do, in this chapter we are going to know about numbers. Know more about numbers, from what is their properties, or how can we compare them, and next is how can we represent them, and many other things. In this chapter we are going to know our numbers. So let's begin it. Now first is the comparing numbers. First we have to, if we have too much numbers, what we have to do, we have to compare them. How can we compare? Now first question is that why we compare and what we get in it. We comparing numbers to know which one is higher or which one is smaller. You can also say we can comparing number to know which one is greatest or which one is lowest. So the first you think, numbers are compared to check which one is higher or which one is smaller than the others. Now whenever we are comparing numbers, two conditions must be arise. First, that first thing will happen, that the numbers are same in digits. What does the digit means? If you can say the 10 and 31, these numbers are different, but you can see both having two digit number, both are two digit number. You get, when you count the ones, tens, then you get two digit number. Yeah, two digit number. So what does it mean? That when the digits are same. And in second condition, what, when we comparing 10 and 111. Now you can see 10 is a two digit number and 111 is a three digit number. So two cases are, the first one is comparing number when the total number of digit is different, and second, comparing numbers when total number of digit is same. Now what we have to, you can see it here, if the number of digits in the numbers are different, if the number of digits in the number are different, same example, the 10 and 111 number of digits are different. So what we have to do, the number having more digit is greater and other is smaller. So what we can see from here, if you are comparing 11 and 10, which one is greater? Yes, you all are right, 111 is greater. Why? Because it contains 3 digit and 10 contains 2 digit. We can easily say that. Also example here, you all can see that 752 and 82. 752 is higher because it contains 3 digit number and 82 is contained only 2 digit number, so it is smaller. I think you all get the point or all the concept. Now move on the second point or second case, comparing numbers when the total number of digit is same. What happens when total number of digit is same? If the number of digit in the numbers are equal, what when the number of digit are equal, what does it mean? What does the mean of number of digit are equal? You can see that 100 and 115 both contain 3-digit number. Both are 3-digit number. Now how can we compare them? The second case, the second condition, we understand it here with the example that consider two numbers, one is 520 and another one is 673. The number of digits are same. You can see that 520 is also a 3-digit number and 673 is also a 3-digit number. Number of digits is same. So what is change here? When we are going to the highest place, the highest place is 100. The 100 digit, you can see in the first one it is 5 and in the second one it is 6. So which one is higher or which one is greater among these? The 6 is greater. So you can see that 6 is higher than 5. Then 673 is higher and 520 is smaller. I think you all got the point. Let's move on the next concept. The next is here. Yes, as we have done quite a lot of this earlier. You all think that we do many things earlier. We are comparing numbers and we also know now the concept of how to compare number, how to know which one is greatest or which one is smallest. So now what we have to do, you all can see two problems on your screen behind me. So what you have to do, the first one is we have to write which one is greatest among these. Now this is the first case which we are talking about. So what is it? There, as you can see, that there are four different numbers. The first one is 92, which is 2-digit number. Second one is 392, which is 3-digit number. Next one is 4456, which is a 4-digit number, and next is 89,742, which is a 5-digit number. So the first case is the number which contain more digit or which is higher in the number of digit is greatest. So here which one is greatest? Here the last one which contains 5 number of digits, so it is greatest. I think you all get. So the answer of first is 89,742 is the greatest number among others. I think you all get the point. Now on the second is, you can see all these four numbers contain equal number of digits. So how we know which one is greater? The easiest way, we have to compare the quantities. So first we compare which one is highest place. Highest place is 1000, so at the 1000 place, which number is greatest? Here the is 9. So how many number is having the highest place at the 9? So there are 3 numbers. Now we move on the second, because with the 1000 concept there are 3 number, we can't tell which one is greater. So we move on the 100. When we comparing to the 100, you can see that at the 100th place 2 digit contains same number, which is 2. So now we have 2 numbers, we can't tell that which one is greatest. So now we move on the one more further step, which is comparing the 10th digit. Here the in the first number you can see that it is 9201. The 10th digit is 0 and in the second it is 1. So which one is greatest? It is clear that 1 is greatest. So 9210 is greatest among others. I think you all got the concept. Let's move on the last part of our session, which is homework for you all. What you have to do, you can see some questions behind me on the screen. What you have to do, first you have to solve these questions and in your notebook. After it, take a pic of it. If you are on the online school portal, you can see a option of upload assignment. You can upload this there, or if you are not registered there, what you have to do, you have to take these pics and you can send this by our school official WhatsApp number or by any other method. I think this is enough for today. Okay, after completing of this video, don't just move on another video. Go and solve these questions. Okay, God bless you all.